Here, if E1 is the eccentricity of the hyperbola, x square divided by 16 plus y square by 25 is equal to 1, and E2 is the eccentricity of the hyperbola passing through the foci of the ellipse, and E1 into E2 is equal to 1, then the equation of the hyperbola is what here? Okay. So here in this case, equation of ellipse here. Okay. So x square divided by 16 plus y square divided by 25 is equal to 1 here. Okay. Be the ellipse. They already given is E1 is the eccentricity here. Therefore, E1 square is equal to, okay, here 16 is less than 25. If 16 is less than 25, in that case the formula is E square is equal to 1 plus 1 minus here, 1 minus half. Okay, so A square divided by B square. Therefore 1 minus half. Okay, here A square is 16 and B square is 25 here. Therefore, 16 divided by 25 here. Okay. A square is 16 and B square is 25. So, we use there 1 minus 16 divided by 25. So, 25 is the LCM here. 25 is the LCM. 25 ones are 25 minus 16 becomes 9 here. 9 upon 25. Therefore, E1 is equal to 3 divided by 5. So eccentricity of this ellipse is 3 divided by 5. Okay. And they given here E1 into E2 is equal to 1 here. Okay. So E1 into E2 is equal to 1 here. They already given here. Therefore E1 is 3 upon 5. Use here. So therefore 3 divided by 5 into E2 is equal to 1 here. Yes, E2 is equal to 5 divided by 3 here. Okay. So, E2 is the eccentricity of the hyperbola. So, E2 is equal to 5 divided by 3. And one more condition they given here. The hyperbola passing through foci of the ellipse here. Foci of the ellipse. Okay. So, foci of this ellipse is. Okay. And foci of ellipse is so therefore here 0 plus or minus b into e f, that is equal to 0 comma plus or minus. Okay, here b value here, you know, a square is 16, b square is 25, and so b value is 5 here. Therefore, so it is a 5 into, so E1, okay, so here E1, so E1 is equal to 3 divided by 5, so 3 divided by 5, okay, so in this case they given here, what they given here, E1 is a eccentricity of the ellipse here, hence you take a 0 plus or minus b into E1. E1 is 3 upon 5. Hence, 5 and 5 cancels here. So, 0 plus or minus 5 here. Sorry, 3. 5 can cancels here. So, 0 plus or minus 3. Okay. So, in these 4 options here, okay. Obviously, here the option means third option. Third option satisfying this one here. Means this ellipse. Sorry, this hyperbola passing to the point 0, 3. X value is 0, y value is 3. Okay, y x value is 0, y value is 3. Then obviously it is not satisfying here. Then observe this one here. Put x value is 0 and y value 3. Therefore, this becomes 0. 9 upon 9 cancels. So remaining is minus 1. Minus 1 equal to minus 1 here. Therefore, here it is not the third option here. Obviously, second option is correct here. Therefore, option B is a satisfying a these are conditions here. Therefore, B is correct answer. Okay, because here if you put x value 0 here, put x value 0 and y value 3 here, okay, then this becomes a 0, 9 and cancels, remaining is minus 1 equal to minus 1. So, and also here eccentricity of the hypotenuse of 5 by 3, just observe here, okay. Here it's a 16 here. A square is a 16, B square is a 9. Okay. Therefore, E2 is equal to 1 plus A square divided by B square here. 1 plus A square is a 16 here. So 16 divided by 9. So therefore, 9 ones are 9. 9 plus 16 becomes a 25. 25 divided by 9. Yes, E2 is equal to 5 divided by 3. It is a 5 upon 3. Therefore, in this case, eccentricity is a 5 by 3 as well as it passes through 0 plus or minus 3. Hence, B is the correct option. The next example, if E and E dash with the eccentricity, E and E dash with the eccentricity of two conics, x equal to 0 and S dash is equal to 0. If E square plus E dash square is equal to 3, then both S and S dash can be hyperbolas, ellipses, parabolas and none of these here. Okay. So both should be, it must be parabola or it is a ellipse or it is a parabola. Fourth option is none of these here. Okay. Therefore, we know that. Okay. For a parabola, eccentricity is always equal to 1 here. Okay. So, if for the parabola, eccentricity is 1. Therefore, if eccentricity is 1, then E dash is also 1 here. Then this condition not satisfying here. Okay. Therefore, E dash is equal to 1 here. Therefore, E square plus E dash square is not is equal to 3. Okay, because for parabola, eccentricity is 1 and E dash equal to 1 here. E dash is so eccentricity of one more conic here. Okay, so E dash is also 1 here. Hence, the condition not satisfying here. For ellipse here, again for ellipse, okay. So, eccentricity always 1, less than 1 here. Therefore, E dash is also less than 1 here. E is the eccentricity of a first conic here, S equal to 0. And E dash is the eccentricity of a second conic. Therefore, if E is 1, then E dash is also 1. Again, the condition not satisfying here. Okay. Therefore, E square plus E dash square, okay, not satisfying here, is equal to 3, not satisfying. Okay, then for a hyperbola, so for hyperbola, eccentricity is greater than 1 here, it is important here, eccentricity is greater than 1. Therefore, E dash is also greater than 1. Therefore, E dash is greater than 1. Therefore, the condition E square plus E dash square is equal to 3 satisfy. The condition satisfied. Therefore, in this case, both must be hyperbola. First option is correct here. Okay. For hyperbola is E is equal to 1. For ellipse, E less than 1, eccentricity less than hyperbola, eccentricity is greater than 1. And then obviously the equation E square plus E dash square equal to 3 satisfying here. Yes, both should be hyperbolas. So option is correct here.